Let's look at the top pro wrestling matches of the week, the best and the worst of the week, and we will start with the worst. It was a mixed bag for the week where women's wrestling is concerned. There are some women's matches in the top, but all three of the worst matches come from women's wrestling this past week, and we will start at number three with NXT and Alba Fyre versus Mandy Rose in a last woman standing match. This match wasn't bad. It is just that the fact that the WWE already had a last woman standing match at the beginning of this month with Bianca Belair and Bayley, who blew it out of the park. So this match in comparison, it was mediocre. And then you compare it to that match and it comes off as not that great. Plus it had interference on the ending. That's why it is the third worst match of the week. Coming in at number two was over on Dynamite, a match between Toni Storm and Anna Jay was just a very flat, boring match that the audience didn't care about. Toni Storm's women's title reign is kind of like this, just not that entertaining and pretty much just flat like this match was. I don't think this match really did anything for any of these women. And that brings us to number one, the worst match of the week. Shayna Baszler versus Shotzi. This is to promote the match between Shotzi and Ronda Rousey coming up at Survivor Series. This match just kind of showed the state of the women's division on SmackDown. It is just not good. And if you go back and watch this match, you will see why. There is not any star power on the women's SmackDown division outside of Ronda Rousey and maybe Liv Morgan. I don't really think this match elevated Shotzi despite her getting the roll-up win of Doom. It was what it was, and it was the worst match of the week. But let's get to our top matches of the week. Coming in at number five was over on Raw, the match between Finn Balor and Seth Rollins.
Rollins grabs hold of the Prince. Oh my God!
They didn't necessarily hit it out of the park, but I thought that the dynamics of this match were good.
Stop, but wait a second!
And we were forced to not assume. Wait a minute! No!
Get this! Finn Balor now! Kick out!
These two can put on a show when they did just that. It was booked well in the end. It went on the outside of the ring. It became the OC versus Judgment Day, and Seth Rollins ends up keeping his title in the match over Finn Balor.
Rollins! Here we go!
At number four was from Full Gear last night, Saraya versus Britt Baker. Saraya's return to the ring. And this was one of the better AEW women's matches ever because of the fact that it actually told a story. And you don't always get this from AEW women's matches or AEW matches, period.
The entire match.
Oh, mid break.
But they were able to tell that here. Working on Saraya's past injured neck here told the story. She was really the underdog of the match, her having ring rust. Britt Baker, and Saraya said this in an interview, Britt Baker kind of had to carry her through some of this match. This was her first return to the ring in 5 years. I think they pulled it off well. It wasn't a bunch of flips and flying and a bunch of spots. It instead was a mat wrestling, told the story. And it worked well. Saraya was the underdog coming back from this past injury, fighting back into this match to win. Good story here. And number three was a last woman standing match, a last knockout standing match from Impact Wrestling. Like I said about the last woman standing match on NXT, kind of doing all these last woman standing matches in the same month after Bianca Belair and Bayley already blew it out of the water is a bit much. It kind of makes the match mean less if you're going to be doing so much of them in the same month. But I think this match did come through. I think they had a lot of good spots. I think they also told a story of the heart that Jordynne Grace has. She is a fighting champion. I think her reign as champion has been going very well for Impact, and I liked the fact that they got a little creative. Instead of having a table, Jordynne Grace pulled out this door from under the ring and put Masha Slamovich through the door to win the last knockout standing match.
Buster up. No way.
Going up off the stairs here.
And number two comes from NXT, Apollo Crews versus JD McDonagh. This is the second week in a row that JD McDonagh is in my matches, the top matches of the week. This match was a very intense match. The pace was great, the storytelling was great, and the upset was also great. After building up JD McDonagh last week, Apollo Crews gets the victory here. Hopefully that doesn't lead to 50-50 booking with these two, but this match by itself was great and a great win for Apollo Crews. Coming in at number one is from Full Gear for the ROH World Title, Chris Jericho versus Bryan Danielson versus Sammy Guevara versus Claudio Castagnoli. It was an intense match. I love the dynamics of the match. For me, it was the dynamics that made this match work, because you have Danielson and Claudio that want to work together. You have Sammy and Jericho that want to work together. Of course, those two eventually have to turn on each other within the match, because it is every man for themselves. I thought they told this story well. Everybody was able to get their shit in, if you will. But Jericho pulling out the win in the end, I think Jericho showed he can still bring it in a high intensity match at his big age. It all worked out in the end, and it was the best match of the week in pro wrestling.